Sous l'appellation
interdisciplinarity, we refer to different teaching methods, which I'm going to describe, and I'm going to try and tell you which will help us meet our objectives for education for sustainable development. In schools, the division into various disciplines prepares our students for further studies and excellence and highly specialized studies, except that in our daily life, we are facing complex problems and we should ask ourselves what should be the contribution of the school teaching. In our school curricula, obviously, we have differences based on the local state, but there are also other ideas such as how to help a child apprehend complex problems, how to help a child have a critical and autonomous thought, how to help a child make choices based on ethical criteria and be curious enough to acquire more knowledge and look for information and place them in the right perspective. These are the objectives which are not used specifically in one discipline, but can be present at the interface of several disciplines. And this is where interdisciplinarity and transdisciplinarity can play a role. Now, the global project to develop a child's mind refers to education for sustainable development in particular. In Switzerland, among the first three aims, it is clearly said that it's aiming at acquiring more awareness, openness to others and citizen responsibility, becoming aware of the complexity and the interdependence, and developing a responsible attitude, an active attitude for sustainable development. In the French Ministry of Education reminds that education for sustainable development should train children for a scientific approach so that each citizen will be able to make choices and take commitments based on an informed reflection, and this should also lead to a reflection on values and awareness of individual responsibilities and collective responsibilities and the necessary solidarity between the territories, between generations and within generations. Finally, Belgium refers to several names. Sometimes they talk about education relative to environment or education for sustainable development. Both are based on a global and systemic approach of education and the development of a critical mind and a citizen behavior. Learning within disciplines opens the mind towards interdisciplinary education, and education to citizen relationships and behavior requires openness, participation, and ethics, and this applies also to environmental issues. Education for sustainable development uses legislative texts which push the children to depart from the disciplinary yoke and open their minds following the breakdown of the barriers. However, the documents do not explain how this can be achieved, and the teachers will make their own interpretation of the vision they have on how to best break the barriers between disciplines. And I would like to take you on a round trip so that you understand what these words refer to. I will not spend too much time on multidisciplinarity, although this may be slightly ambiguous, but multidisciplinarity is only a system that we inherited from Jules Ferry and the university system. In order to meet the objective for education for sustainable development, multidisciplinarity is useless. Now, in pluridisciplinarity, we have several disciplines with a common object being studied. The object is studied by each discipline with specific tools. This is the most used model in secondary schools and high schools. The teachers talk to each other and they agree on the object or subject that will be studied by all separately. And this system will allow to meet the disciplinary objective of each of the disciplines. The connections, if they are spotted by the students, may provide a context or a common problem studied in various disciplines. According to Diemer, the conceptual framework of pluridisciplinarity is based on three principles: discipline, under the limelight, juxtaposition of the various skills and knowledge acquired through the disciplines and an association principle because the disciplines are aiming for the same object. As Valkoviak said, it is all about getting the disciplines to start a dialogue. Pluridisciplinary can therefore be construed as the first step towards a link between disciplines and the very beginning of a systemic approach. But this teaching approach is very limited because in complex problems, too many elements do not belong to any of the disciplines. And actually, teaching programs know this, and in Switzerland, the Plan d'études romans offers a general training, which is a transversal sort of training. According to the official documents, this general training will clarify and render operational teachings which do not happen in school teaching settings. Interdisciplinarity is therefore very often present around a common project. The various disciplines will serve the project without losing their autonomy. There is the to and fro of information between the project's needs and the disciplines involved. For an interdisciplinary teaching, the authors who study the subject say that collaboration between the people representing the various disciplines is absolutely essential. And this dialogue, this consultation, will require first the systemic global approach of the problem, and this is absolutely essential, and later the parameters characterizing each discipline will be involved. Epistemology, didactic, teaching parameters will allow each of the disciplines to analyze with its own tools the problem submitted in order to find alternative solutions. According to Reggie Collet, the conceptual framework for interdisciplinarity is based on three principles. Integration: every interdisciplinary project requires that at least two disciplines complement each other. A collaboration principle: the representatives of the various disciplines must start a dialogue in order to use their expertise to solve a problem or to compare their theoretical frame. And a synthesis principle: to provide a new representation of reality. According to Diemer, the conceptual framework of transdisciplinarity is based on three principles: the systemic principle, whereby the world can be seen in a new way, a principle of complexity, as was described previously, and a principle of reflexivity. Now, this one is absolutely determining because, according to this principle, the individual should integrate himself in the object being studied, because the individual will participate in cultural traditions depending on the different cultural frameworks, and all the elements must be understood in order to for the student to understand the relationship he has with the object, and therefore the world of value will be in agreement with the world of knowledge to analyze the problem jointly. In transdisciplinarity, the discipline as such disappears for the benefit of a kind of knowledge which can be found at the intersection of the various disciplines. This is probably the most remote vision from current practices, but it is paradoxically the one that will lead us towards acquisition of new skills. Because by trying to develop the capacity to communicate, discuss, provide arguments, adopt a systemic and a prospective vision, and those are only examples for sustainable development education, the disciplinary content is only the framework on which the competence will develop. Obviously, this frame will be essential and remain essential, but what are the points of convergence on which the transdisciplinary approach can rest? Well, they can be defined through concepts that may be called transdisciplinary. According to the author, the name will change, but still, we're still talking about convergence, points of convergence of disciplines. Jourdan calls them transversal, Maurice and Ankeler call them integrators, and Stengers calls them nomadic. We have several names suggested here based on our work. In the center, we have the nucleus, like a nucleus of an atom, with the notions of space, time, material, and energy. And all around, orbiting around the nucleus, we have balance, information, evolution, concept which can be found in exact sciences and human sciences, in social approaches, economic, ecological, political, and cultural approaches. The reasoning, the thought, the state of mind required by work on these concepts goes well beyond the acknowledged knowledge in order to include elements that belong to no discipline, such as the basis for complex thought.